Very early on in my career, I learned about chaos and deterministic systems, and that was just very impressive to me. I study the motion of the planets from the time of Newton up until the 60s. The consensus viewpoint was that the motion of the planets was regular, and it was just a matter of finding more powerful mathematical tools to prove that. There's a famous problem in the distribution of asteroids called the Kirkwood gap problem. If you look at the number of asteroids versus distance from the sun, then that distribution shows gaps at near resonances with Jupiter. So for instance, there's a gap at the 3-to-1 resonance where the asteroid goes around the sun three times every time Jupiter goes around once. What I did to study this problem was to invent a new integration method. And that allowed me to study the motion over much longer times than people had studied before. And I found chaotic behavior in the motion of asteroids near resonances. The property of the chaotic behavior of these asteroids is that they're all catastrophic. Their eccentricities increase to the point that they cross planetary orbits and even fall into the sun. So it turns out that the chaotic orbits are all removed and the regular orbits remain, and that's what forms the Kirkwood gaps. Gerald Sussman is a computer scientist, but he's also an amateur astronomer. And he also builds hardware. He heard about my result concerning the motion of asteroids. So what he did was to say, if I don't believe your integrator, but I can build you a computer to do the same calculation. And so he built this computer, the digital orrery. Then we used that, we collaborated together to use that computer to study the motion of Pluto. Pluto has a sort of suspicious orbit. It is resonant with Neptune. It goes around the sun twice for every three times Neptune goes around the sun. It took the calculation, even on a special purpose computer, took 6 months. And what we found was that the motion of Pluto is indeed chaotic. It shows sensitive dependence on initial conditions. And what this means in practice is that if you change the position of Pluto by 1 millimeter, then in 100 million years, it will be on the opposite side of the sun. Jacques Lascar was inspired by that result and studied the evolution of the whole solar system using an approximation of the equations of motion and showed that the whole solar system evolved chaotically. Because the calculation involved approximations, we wanted to do a full simulation of Newton's equations with relativistic corrections to see if Lascar was correct. Gerald Sussman built another supercomputer, and I developed a new algorithm with my student Matt Holman. And combined, these two allowed us to study the evolution of the whole solar system without approximation. And we found that indeed the solar system, including the Earth, evolves chaotically with a 5 million year Lyapunov time. This is most strongly manifest in the motion of Mercury, where the eccentricity of Mercury's orbit can vary by a factor of 2 over billion year timescales. In some simulations, Mercury develops such a large eccentricity that it can collide with Venus. So the chaotic behavior of the motion of the planets may lead to the instability of the planetary system on long timescales. I used to give many lectures on the chaotic behavior of the solar system. I had read about the double pendulum mathematically. It's a very intriguing illustration of chaotic behavior. And so I asked my class if anyone would be interested in building one. And Jayant Sharma said yes. And then I went around the country showing it. People never tire of watching the double pendulum.